corner. We just made a loop around here to catch this Delta and point. Raised our altitude a little bit. We're up to, what, about 300?
300.
Yeah. I think it'll be better to stay up there.
Yeah.
And here we've got Pebbly Sand Beach. Cobble, boulder over on the right. Pebbly sand beaches, a little bit of wetland on that one. Wide sand delta here with wetlands rimming all around the edges. Braided stream channel. Can't tell whether there's eelgrass in there. It looks like eelgrass in the low portion of the intertidal. Kelp offshore, Nereocystis. Series of little tidal flats and all these little indentations, and they are grading from a muddy sand up to a pebbly sand in the upper intertidal and a wetland. There's another little one with wetlands around the edge and a mud flat in the middle, or a sandy mud flat. And we do have kelp in the near shore, wetlands in the high tide platform areas. There's some intertidal banding. Again, we're starting to see that purpley brown algae in the lower intertidal. Bit of a moderate to low energy area here, locally generated waves. And coming up to another delta, looks like the surface is mostly pebbly sand, a little bit of coal boulder up on the north side. Wetland up there, patchy eelgrass offshore. Wetland up there.
3 minutes ago.
Bit of wetland, and it does look like, I can't really tell whether there's eelgrass on the offshore. Sandy pebble delta, a little bit of cobble material around the edges. Definitely kelp in the offshore, Macrocystis. Very narrow intertidal with boulder veneer over bedrock. This is a delta area. There's wetlands up above there, tidal flats all along the margins. There's very large wetlands inland, and sand flats in the middle by the channels, and it looks like boulder cobble right up under the tree canopy. Of pebble, cobble, sand on that delta. A little bit of wetland patch. There's fucus in the upper intertidal zone. Can't see what's in the subtidal. There's a lot of turbidity right along the shore. Makes it the water visibility is not nearly as good as over in the Charlottes. Here we're back into this purpley algae in the lower intertidal. Thank you. sand, a long continuous coast, a rocky ramp. And our data logger looks good. And our recorder looks good. That's a cobble boulder veneer at the mouth of that stream, and then back into a rock ramp shoreline with a boulder veneer. Intertidal biota, we've definitely got a fucus band, then it looks like a bear band, and then more fucus, another bear band, and then the purple-brown algae right now near the low water line, and that's kind of discontinuous, so it's not every place. Sections of coastline, there's not much fucus. I guess it's just too dry for the fucus to survive. And that beach is cobble up in the upper intertidal, graded down to sand in the lower intertidal. Pretty much either bare rock or rock with a veneer of boulder and cobble. Sort of purple brown algae in the lower portion of the intertidal on the rocks. There's a little delta, pebble cobble veneer over sand. Can't see into the subtidal to see if there's eelgrass. Small patches of kelp. If we could get a little closer, Dan, that'd work. There's sort of a high tide bench. I'm not sure why that's formed, but there's you see it quite often along here. Rocky ramp shoreline.